to another segment of Women Lead TV, brought to you by Connected Women of Influence. I'm Michelle Bergquist, your host of Badass Business Women. With me today as my featured guest is a badass businesswoman, and I'm delighted to introduce Sheila Netti, who's the CEO of Netti Wealth Coaching. Correct, Sheila?
Yes,
you are badass, right?
Because
you deal with numbers and wealth all the time. I'm dying for you to share with our listeners. You're not a financial planner. You're not a financial advisor, but share what you do for women and businesses, and you know how you help them with their wealth strategies.
Well, I actually work mostly with women, but professionals or women professionals and corporate, as well as entrepreneurs.
Okay.
And basically working with women who are not sure they're going to hit whatever their goals are, particularly for retirement or the lifestyle they want to achieve, and they've been anxious and worried about money and are not really clear on
Isn't that every woman?
Exactly.
Every woman is anxious about money.
And so I actually help them lay out a plan that will definitely make their financial dreams, I like to say, not only possible, but inevitable.
I love it. And not everybody has the same dream, which is interesting because for me growing up, it was always, you know, go travel. And it's like, you know, buy the beach house on the home on the beach house. Let's got to get that right. At the same time, I'm like, no, I'm not a traveler. I'm like, to me, it's like a grand day would be to go to Disneyland and buy out the park and have two-year-olds go crazy, you know, and give back that way. So I'm curious, like, what are some of the things that, you know, when a woman comes to you, it's like, what is it that they're, how do you help them, I think is the question, right?
Well,
everyone's anxious.
Everybody's anxious, particularly nowadays when really no one's been taught about finances. This is something that I really realized is that it's so key. You're not taught this in school. So how do you pick this up? Mm-hmm. You know, some of the women I've worked with have read books, but they still couldn't quite piece it together.
Right.
And so I kind of help bridge that gap between what you may have read and now you can actually put it in place.
I love that.
Yeah, so I actually go through and work with them, not only in the actual strategies or the nuts and bolts of the numbers and kind of make the not so scary, but I also work with the mindset. So a lot of women I run into have so many issues when it comes to their thoughts around money, their beliefs around money, things they don't even understand that they were programmed with when they were children.
Well, and you shared a fun fact with me today, and that is you actually retired at the mid-50s.
55,
How the hell did you do that? And I'm ready to take notes. Can you share with us on our
Well,
viewers?
I was one of those people that started at a young age. So I really 12? Just started at 20. I started saving money at 20, but I also ran into some snags along the way. So it wasn't like a quick meteoric rise where I actually got there really fast. I ended up starting well as far as saving, but I also come from a very poor background. My parents did not have a lot of money. I grew up in New York in Harlem in what's called the projects, which is not a great neighborhood, with drug addicts around, the drug addicts on one side, the drug dealers on the other. And, but at that point when I was young, I decided I didn't want this life. Like I did not want to be in this area. There had to be a better way. My dad was working two jobs and I kept thinking there's got to be a better way. So I decided at that point that I was going to change my life, that I was going to be different, that this wasn't going to be my life. And it turned out it wasn't. My dad eventually did do really well too, but it took that focus to be able to do it. For me,
how did you learn about the strategies to employ? I mean, did you just try new things? Did you go to some classes or programs or the University of How to Make a Lot of Money? I mean, I'm curious. Like, how did you learn something like that? Because there's so many books and it's so confusing. You know, I mean, I came from commercial banking, so for me, it was like I understood discount brokerage, but never small, mid cap, and large funds. And then it's like, if I can just share, there was this one book, and maybe you knew of it. In the 80s, there was this book called The Beardstown Ladies Investment Guide.
Yes.
Oh, my God. I want to start an investment club in CWI. I don't know if you can help me with that, but I want to do that for our members. And it just changed everything, like how to research stocks and things like that. So I'm back to how did you learn all this? And how then obviously now you're helping women do that. But how did you learn all this, Miss Smarty Pants? It's a lot to learn.
I basically read tons of books. I mean, because I have an MBA. But I did not learn how to deal with my money in an MBA. I didn't get that till I was a little older.
Okay.
But I did not learn that there. I basically had to go through the School of Hard Knocks, reading everything I could get my hands on about money, investing, and then understanding what it would take, like really being able to estimate the amount of money it would take to really get where I wanted to go.
Okay.
So
did you have a shoe budget? Did you have a purse budget? How do we? So many women are like, gotta have the whatever they're called. I'm not in that. But how do you help women with that piece of it, right? Because it's almost like that's a line item as a budget item.
It is. I basically like to call it saving your way out of debt. So if you have debt, there's a way to save, which means you are working through living your life at the same time that you're also working yourself out of debt, and also eliminating the cycle. Because a lot of women, like I did for a while, went through a cycle of debt. They would go in, out of debt. They'd say, okay, I'm done with this. I'm going to go ahead and pull out everything they have and get rid of the debt.
That'd be me.
And then next thing you know, they're back in it again.
Like you feel good about it for a moment, and then you're back to doing the same old habits, right?
Right. And that comes back to that mindset where we're breaking those habits, working on shifting that. Right. And then we're also looking at how do I live a life, enjoy my life, but at the same time still reach and shoot for those goals. And that's what I really help women do. It is possible because I've done it and I was still able to retire.
Oh, what a great sounding. And for you, with the kind of women you work with, like what are women dealing with at the time which it's best where you come in to serve? Like they're not already wealthy. I mean, can you work with any woman who's serious about it and then they become regimented? Tell a little bit of how,
I can work with any woman. And I do work with some men, so
they don't need us. They don't need us. You know, what is the statistic? They say women are coming into the biggest amount of wealth in any generation. And we need to be smarter about money. So this is fabulous.
Yeah, definitely. And the whole reason I got into this, I mean, so I retired at 55, so I could have stopped, right? I could have just relaxed. I did a little bit of that. I did some traveling.
Okay, you did spend a little bit.
I did spend a little money.
Went
traveling and decided that, you know, I started noticing that the conversation around money for so many people in my life and around me was not very empowering. And so I realized that if I wanted to have a bigger impact on the world and really leave a legacy, I needed to figure out how to help get this message out, change the entire conversation around money to one of empowerment, to one of impact, so that it was no longer just going to be me. It wasn't just here and there you found an anecdote of this person can do it or that person can do it. I could actually help them learn, women particularly, learn how, and then they could teach their children.
And that's what really women want to do. Sure, the next generation.
Change
the
generational wealth so that we actually create generational wealth.
I can't, even as a banker, I can't tell you. And for me, I'm not really sophisticated. I know a little bit to be dangerous. I know stuff, but not everything. And what's interesting, even in banking, I would get so many women that would come in when their spouse passed away, and they'd just be lost. I mean, how to balance a checkbook. You know, they don't teach you that. Maybe they do in school now for some of the side interests for kids. But with a woman, how do you sit down and determine what the plan is? And, can you just share a little bit about that, of how you go through that with a woman?
Well, the biggest thing I do at first, as I said before, is the mindset piece. So we really have to delve into that. And then I really open it up and set them dream. Mm. Like, what do you truly want in your life? What do you truly are dreaming of? What does that look like? And really giving yourself the chance to dream, because most women these days, they're just doing something for this person and that person.
Do they struggle with that?
They do.
Yeah,
more often than not, everyone,
they're
struggle.
Caregivers,
they're
right?
Caregivers,
we are caregivers.
And they're so focused on their children or focused on what they need or their husbands need. And they're not really focused on themselves. And I have to help them kind of see that by doing the work on themselves and really focusing on their dreams, they can actually help everyone else. So once we get through that and we now have their dream, like what is it they really want, now we start getting into the nuts and bolts. Because now that basically is the fuel that helps you do all the harder work.
Right.
Because now you get into the numbers. But I also call it learning the secret language of money.
Ooh.
So basically,
that's going to be a book for you someday, isn't it? I hope. Yeah, we put it out there, folks. It's going to be a book. I love it.
And basically, now we get into the numbers. Now we've done all the other work to kind of shift you and see why we need to do this work.
Okay.
And then we go into the numbers. And then once we kind of work through that, whatever debt the person has, if she's dealing with a lot of debt, we work through how to, as I said, save your way out of debt. And also, so at the same time we're getting with the debt, we're also increasing the savings. And we now have an idea of where you want to go. What does that number look like? Now we know how to, where the destination is.
Okay.
Now we start laying out the I want to say the growth work, mm-hmm. which is now we have some money, we start investing. So I help them understand.
Stay on the plan.
Mm-hmm. How do you invest the money? Because a lot of times most people don't know how to manage the money. They don't know how to invest it or grow it. And so I actually help them learn the basics of that to make sure they understand so they can work with a financial advisor, because I'm not a financial advisor, I'm a coach, and I'm helping them work more, I want to say they are the decision makers mm-hmm. and they're in control, mm-hmm. and it basically allows them to take their power back.
And I love that. I mean, so interesting. Like, let's say a woman is part of a family unit, right? So there's a spouse, maybe mm-hmm. some kids. Is it usually then when you're working with a woman and who has a family that it's like you work with the with both spouses, or is it just the woman and then she is the influencer to say, we're going to do this, my wonderful spouse?
So far I've actually just worked with the woman and they actually then interface with their spouse.
Okay.
So, and that has, I think that's going to shift somewhat when we get into some of the, I want to say as things get a little bit tighter perhaps, or their situation may be a little bit more rough, mm-hmm. then the spouse can get involved, and they are certainly welcome to get involved. I don't have a problem with working with both, but right now, so far, my experience has been that I've been working with the woman who then, more often than not, is the one managing the household. They may not be running the investments, but they're at least, in some cases, at least the ones I've been dealing, they've been dealing with the money on a day-to-day basis of paying the bills. And that process.
I feel like you're a best kept secret. You know, I know there's like the Susie Orman out there, if that's, she's still relevant, which I know she is. I'm teasing. But, you know, she's been such a powerhouse for like the little things to do. And yet, you know, there's Dave Ramsey who talks about so many things about, you know, the cash, you know, and how to like maintain your cash and, you know, pay things out differently and be really on track with it. For you, it's like, what, can you give an example of maybe a woman that you've worked with, and then not who, of course, although mm-hmm. I'd love okay. to know, is what was the outcome? I mean, what were they looking to do, and then how is their, obviously, their financial situation better off?
Well, the example I brought with one woman that I worked with, where they had some money saved, mm-hmm. but she wasn't sure if it was going to get her on the path. She wasn't sure if she could hit retirement. They're in her 40s, and so she wasn't clear. So she also wasn't clear on what did she really want the money to do.
Oh, right.
So she had inherited some money and as well, so she was also trying to figure out, navigate that, but she felt like she really did not have the knowledge of what it took to really manage it, as well as to really grow it. Now, she had, of course, some things under advisement of a financial advisor, a management of a financial advisor, but she didn't feel confident in where this was going. So I worked with her on that first piece, the mindset.
I totally get that.
And the vision. And then we got into the numbers, where she felt that was her big thing. Like, she needed to understand how could she manage this in a way that worked for her, mm-hmm. and also gave her the insight and the power to figure out how she could still have her purse that she wanted or her clothes that she wanted. But
we all also want something there on that one. It's got to make us feel good.
Exactly. But also working through the priorities of that. And so she felt really, really good. And so now we're, you know, with her, we're now into the investing side. But she was like, she, you know, was fine with understanding all those pieces. And now we're just working out the final map.
That's so cool.
Of where
and she knows what she wants to do. And
she knows exactly what she wants to do. We've laid out her priorities. She has some plans on doing some remodeling to her home. And so we have the money set aside for that. And so she's feeling so confident mm-hmm. that now she has a real plan and she knows where the money is going. The fun part about that with working with her was the fact that she found over $2,000 she didn't even know that she had hanging out in different places until we dug into the bills.
Whoa.
She didn't know that some of the companies she was working with actually had excess funds.
That's where the shoe bill went. Yeah, right. The shoe purchase. I love that. You know, and for you, I know you said you're not like a financial advisor. So for you, you're fee-based. And mm-hmm. how do you, is it always the same amount without sharing? Because I know every client's probably different. Do you just scale and suggest what somebody will do based on the scope of work that you're going to help them with over time?
Well, I have a 6-month program
that
I usually start there. Okay. And then depending on the complexity of mm-hmm. their situation, then it can go sometimes to a year. So usually within a year, we will have worked through everything and then be able to, you know, have you on the path where you need to go. And then now you're empowered and now you understand it and now you can teach other people, particularly your children.
Do you have, I know you can do consulting with people and coaching, but do you also are you teaching and training and talking and have workshops on all of this so that you can speak to larger audiences, or what, What is your plan, woman?
My plan is to actually do more workshops. Okay. My ultimate plan is actually to create a foundation where I can actually work with women who probably can't afford to mm-hmm. work with me and actually help spread financial literacy, particularly around That's understanding great. How to grow and manage and invest. And this way, they will be able to, you know, take that information and get started. I feel like that's probably my biggest way to reach as many women as I possibly can.
I love it.
Because I know that not everybody can afford to work with a financial coach and really kind of take them through the process.
There's so many elements you do. And it's like, I think back when my grandparents and even my parents, it's like you just didn't have spend on credit. Add that now to where we're at today, and you've got all those, like, you know, recurring charges and mm-hmm. the subscriptions that it's really difficult to handle all that and getting a handle on your money. I remember when I was, you know, growing up, my grandfather had like columns, like a, mm-hmm. you know, before Excel or yeah. anything on a computer. And it was like, he would go, make sure you write down every single thing that you spend money on. It was just really a great footprint, but I still think we all need to level up. So it's awesome. What would be one last thing you'd want to share with our listeners that, and our viewers that will say, my God, I can do this. I know Call You is one of them. And do you mind sharing your website with everybody, Sheila?
Yeah, sure. My website is SheilaNetti.com. That's SheilaNetti.com. You can reach me there. And the one thing I would say is that you have the ability to take your power back. You just have to open your mind up to the possibility that even though you may have struggled a little bit, it is possible. It is doable.
That's what that just did. I love it. We're going to have you back. And I know you're going to be hosting your own show on money and women. And I can't wait to see what you come up with. So thank you for being my guest today. You will have your guest going forward. That is another Women Lead TV show brought to you by Connected Women of Influence. And we will be back again for another show segment. So thank you again, Sheila.
Thank you.
That's a wrap.